Chicago.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to AM Chicago. Hello, I'm Art Fleming, your guest host for this week on today's show. We're talking with three people that society calls punkers. We're here to find out why they dress this way and how it's affected their lives. Later in the show, we'll hear from our AM audience and invited guests. And by the way, we had an overwhelming response from all of you who wanted to be here today. We thank you and hope that we can see you all here very, very soon. Well, we have with us today 28-year-old George Black. George Black, who lives in Logan Square and works by day as a mail courier and by night as a singer in a band called Stations. Then we also have 30-year-old Alicia Lozano from Rogers Park. She's our only mother here today, and she's brought along her 7-year-old son, Stacy, and we're going to talk with him a little bit later. And finally, 33-year-old Dorian Dvorak from Wilmette, who works in public relations for a nonprofit agency here in Chicago. So we welcome you and welcome you, our studio audience. Let's meet these punkers today. First, George Black. George, I understand that's not your real name.
No, it isn't.
What was your original name, George?
My real name is Patty Smith.
Patty Smith. Can I ask why you changed from Patty Smith to George Black?
I'm a singer, and it's pretty obvious. There's another Patty Smith, very famous singer in America.
So I why George Black?
Well, I'm a fan of George Sand, who was a female writer in the late 1800s, and in order to get her books published, she had to change her name to a male name. And so I'm in the music business, and it's
she was the paramour of
Chopin.
Yes,
correct.
Now, all of you, I'm sure, understand the fact that a lot of people look down upon you in an interesting way, only to the extent that you don't look and dress and really behave like most of us traditional folks. How do you feel about that, George?
Oh, I don't really care. I never really think about what other people's opinion might be or anything. I just do whatever I want to.
Uh-huh.
And once in a while, I'll react to a comment, you know, an adverse comment to me. But otherwise, I really don't care.
Okay, when was this change in your life? At what point?
Oh, when I got out of high school, I started putting a lot of henna on my hair, and it progressed to a crew cut in about 76, 77, which I dyed burgundy. And I was very much into hair fashion.
Okay, so up to 76, you were very traditional, so
to speak. I had just black hair.
Okay, well, what happened then in 77 that you decided, I'm going to change, and change radically, I might add?
Oh, a trip to New York.
Why? What happened there?
I saw a lot of people with burgundy hair and very radical haircuts and things.
Mm-hmm.
And I just fell in love with it, so I started after that.
All right, fine. Let's talk now to our second member of our guest list, and it's Alicia Lozano. Alicia, you are the only mother of the group, right?
Yeah.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special report from ABC News. In Washington, here is Steve Bell.
Thank you. We continue now on AM Chicago, talking to one of our three punkers, Alicia. How long have you been a punker now?
For 4 years, about.
And this had nothing to do with the divorce and...
No, nothing at all.
Now, how do you feel about your son being teased about, hey, there's Ma, and all
that? He gets teased a lot by his his classmates and stuff. And but he doesn't mind it at all. He just... Mm-hmm. Shrugs it off.
All right. Let's meet now our next guest. Now, you have what is called a mohawk, right?
Right.
Did you know that in history the Mohawks were part of the Iroquois Nation, some of the meanest Indians that ever lived? Is there any significance to that?
Sure. I'm real mean.
Oh, yes. Here you are. Now, what keeps your hair up like that?
There's a product like a hairspray that you can put on, and it actually survives even sleeping through.
Now,
you could actually wake up in the morning and still have it.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. Now, you go to work in a public relations office. You do not dress this way.
Definitely not. I wear suits most of the time, and I never would appear with my hair this way.
Why not?
Well, I think they'd throw me out the window.
Really? That's good public relations. They say, come and see our new lady.
I don't think it's quite their style.
You know, I don't want to be nosy, but I notice that on your thigh you have a tattoo.
I do.
Would you mind showing our viewers what the camera one is picking that up? Is there a special significance to that tattoo?
No, not particularly. It's something that I designed myself, and I've had it for about 10 years.
Mm-hmm. And there's no other story about taking that on or off. It's permanent.
That's right.
Doesn't that bother you that you have done, in a way, defaced the Temple of Loveliness?
Defaced it. I've ornamented it.
Ornamented it. I say, are you going to go on and tattoo more of your body? ready?
I do have one other tattoo that's on my lower back.
Well, I'd rather not. Thank you very much. I'll tell you what now. Why don't we go on into our audience and talk to a few of the people here. And if you would stand up, please, and find out what is your name and where are you from?
My name is Norma Stein. I'm the mother of the hairdresser. I'm from Michigan.
I see.
You're visiting.
How do you feel? Your son is the fellow that has done all of this.
Mark
is that
Stein.
Mark.
Right, of Mark and James.
What do you think about that?
I think it's great. I've met all three of these lovely ladies. They're having fun. They're having a ball.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's no different than long hair, mini skirts. They're just
really?
Expressing themselves.
All right. Now, if they are trying to express themselves, why don't they do this themselves rather than going to a Mark Stein to have him design the look?
They're not capable.
They're not capable. It
no,
takes a lot of work, is that it?
Oh, a great deal of work.
Mm-hmm.
Great deal
right.
of time, special cutting. And.
Thank you very much. I do appreciate your chatting with us. And here comes Stacy. Stacy, come here now. You're how old, Stacy?
Hello.
Hello, how old are you?
6.
6 years old. How do you feel about your mom, Alicia, being dressed the way she is?
Nice.
Would you like her to be that way forever, or would you like her to change to a more conservative style?
I don't think he knows that word.
You don't know that word. Well, what about the rest of the people? Do
more
they
normal?
Think your mom is funny looking? They do, but you don't care, do you? You think when you grow up you're going to be a punker? You are. Okay, thank you very much. Sir, would you mind stepping forward? And your name is?
Martin Smith.
Martin Smith.
George.
And where are you from, sir?
Lombard.
Lombard.
And George Black is my daughter.
Your daughter?
Yes.
Oh, I had no idea.
See, I'm dressed as a 1941 punk rocker.
Well, I'm dressed like 1938
all right,
punk
fine, rocker.
Well,
fine.
How do you feel as a father of a rocker?
Well, I feel that if she wants to do it on her own within a certain amount of limit, fine. If she's expressing herself, that's great. But I don't believe that she should live the way I lived
mm-hmm.
if she doesn't want to.
Okay, if you would take her now to a restaurant, a fine restaurant here in Chicago,
mm-hmm.
and everybody starts looking at her, how would you feel, even though she's your daughter?
I stare back at them. They get very uncomfortable. The mm-hmm. guy has a very mean stare.
Have you ever been involved with any negative or venomous reactions to
no,
her?
No. In fact, she delivers for me. I have a delivery service, and many of the people, she goes into some very conservative, very staid offices,
mm-hmm.
and the girls look at her, and they say, hey, that's nice. They like it. It's something different.
Well, you know, she made the change, I understand, in 1976.
That's right.
And are you now in your later years as a senior citizen, not now, in about 20 years from now, you think you're ever going to adopt that?
Thanks for the compliment, but I don't think I will.
Yeah, okay, thank you very much. Let's find another rocker in our audience. Would you mind standing up, please? Okay, hi. What's your name?
Felicia Voigt.
Felicia, and you are from?
Flossmoor.
Okay. How do you feel about the individuality that is expressed by all these rockers?
Oh, I think it's great, because... Mm-hmm. I know that I came into it just trying to express myself as an individual, and I think there's more power to people. You know, it's so easy to follow, you know, but it takes a lot of courage.
Have you ever had any adverse reactions?
Lots of times.
For instance, can you give us one?
People just start harassing you on the street. You know, they'll come up to you, and they'll just say something, you know, blatantly rude, people who don't even know you.
And how do you respond?
I ignore him.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fine. Thank you very much. I do appreciate it. We're going to continue with our audience, my friends. We have some commercial messages, and of course, we'll be back to talk to our audience and our punkers. Join us, won't you? Thank you. Well, we've met our three guest punkers. We are trying to find out the whys and wherefores of their outfits. Let's go now into the audience and see if anybody has a question or two that they would like to ask of these punkers. Your name, sir?
Brian Plant.
Brian Plant. And where are you from?
Winnetka.
Okay. Winnetka. What's your
right.
question?
And my question is it a rebellion? Are you guys trying to be rebellious to society or something like that? Or is it just for your own, you know, you like being that way and you like being looked at that way?
I like looking the way I look. For once, I can wake up in the morning, look in the mirror, and I like the way I look. I'm happy with it. I'm not rebelling against anybody or anything, or I'm not really. I'm just standing for an individual who wants to look the way they want to look without restrictions.
And George?
Yeah, that's the way I feel too,
okay.
actually.
Didn't you not like yourselves in the previous life, so to speak? How do you feel about that, Dorian?
Yeah.
Sure.
You did like yourself?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
Here's a young lady in our audience. May we have your name,
please? Janice Daly. I'm from Tinley Park, Illinois.
Okay, go ahead.
And I was going to ask Dorian in there why you have to change your hairstyle for when you go to work, when that's kind of defeating the purpose of being a punker, I think. Maybe I have the wrong idea of what it's all about, but being yourself all the time, you know, instead of changing your look for...
In my case, I feel that there's more than one thing to life, and I'm perfectly comfortable to act out the other part, too, and wear suits to work. And then I do this also for fun.
You wouldn't
want to
go to work like that? And
No, just, I don't think I'd be comfortable.
That's not your attitude, like, the heck with everybody else, I'll do what I want?
No, not during that time.
So then it's phase one.
But I do
Exhibit
like
A and Exhibit B
different.
For work.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you very much. Who else would like to ask a question? If you will come front and center so we can get together. Your name is?
Hi, my name is Wanda Moore, and I'm from Chicago.
All right, your question is?
My question is, where do you buy your clothes from, and are they very expensive?
No, they aren't. I buy from a lot of resale shops and things.
Yes.
And
you just put them together.
A Pier 1 imports. I really don't have that much money being a musician and not having a record contract yet. But
do you find that ladies, that because of this, companies will be cropping up selling all of this stuff? And in a way, it's reverse psychology.
Oh, punk rock is just like a term for advertising to sell something like Big Mac or something, to sell hamburgers. It's not a large hamburger, it's a Big Mac,
mm-hmm.
you know?
You know, many years ago in the latter 70s, punk rock started in England as a vote against the establishment, so to speak, and word got around the world that anybody who was in punk was involved with drugs. How do you respond to that?
I don't have enough money for drugs.
And Alicia?
I can't because of my son.
Yeah. Oh, but if it wasn't your son?
I didn't mean that.
Any other questions, sir? All right, here's another gentleman. Your name?
My name's Chuck Manders. I'm from Skokie.
Mm-hmm.
And I just have as an observation. I grew up in the 60s, and I had extremely long hair and a beard and a mustache.
So
and
did
I wasn't trying to...
You had a long beard and a mustache?
No beard, okay?
Yeah. Looks like you're
We went through the hippie stage, too.
So, yeah. I wasn't trying to make a statement. I was just trying to feel comfortable and look the best way that I felt I could look at that time.
Yeah.
And I think that's all that we have here.
It's just a phase in your life, and you decided to change it?
At that point in time. This is a phase, and I may change it 10 years from now.
Uh-huh. Okay, fine. How do you respond to that?
That's exactly the way I feel. There are some times when I just have regular straight black hair where I haven't decided what I want to do next. I had straight black hair with just bangs before I did this.
All right, let's think of the future for a moment. In a month from now, this whole thing could change. What are you going to do with your hair? It's going to take forever to grow out.
Oh, I'll find something to do with it.
Are you ever worried,
There's
any
so
of you, about
ideas.
The constant coloring of your hair? How many times have you changed your hair colors?
A lot.
Why? Doesn't this, of
why
course...
Not?
Well, it doesn't... why not? For many reasons. It's not the best thing for your hair.
Well, see, I can cut mine off. I cut mine off, actually, because there was so much dye on my other hair. Mm-hmm. And now I'm starting new again with bleach. But...
Any other questions in the audience? Would you come front and center here, please?
I have a question. Are there different types of punkers? Are there different kinds? Or
yes,
what is your name,
is.
First of all?
Oh, my name is Sue. I'm from Lombard.
Sue, okay. Sue from Lombard. Go ahead.
I have to admit that there are some punk rockers, as so you call them, that are kind of hostile or, you know, because they've been through, you walk down the streets, a lot of people are going to yell at you and you're going to have all kinds of reactions from.
Can you give us a specific reaction that somebody's given to you as they just look at you?
Oh, I don't know. They yell out obscenities all the time or they ask me how much.
Yeah.
Hey, baby.
Well, doesn't Alicia? Did this hurt your feelings inwardly?
No, it doesn't. It makes me feel like they're a little bit ignorant. You know, how would they like it if I was in the car yelling out at them? How much? You know.
Yeah. Do you never respond in kind, though?
No, I never respond. I usually walk away unless something is thrown at me, and then I'll respond and throw something back.
We have three lovely ladies as our guests, and we are going to pause for a commercial word, and we'll be right back. Don't go too far away. In the remaining time that we have talking to our punkers, I have a couple of questions. Ladies, where do you get the most negative responses? Is it from men, from women, from the young, the old?
The age
Alicia.
Range is about 30 to 50, I would say.
In the man or the woman?
Both.
Both, okay.
And the older than 50 love it. They really like
the
it.
The men
so
like
much.
It better?
The women do.
Oh, the
too.
Women too.
They
ah.
just think it's so lovely and so cute because most of the dresses, like earrings or whatever, is something they would want to wear, mm-hmm. you know, themselves. And the younger group, they either yell and scream and like jump up and down and stuff, you know, get like real hyper.
Mm-hmm. But
from
no matter what they say,
like that,
no matter
know?
What they say, you are going to remain punkers and give it your best shot, right?
Right.
Well, good. It's been a pleasure. I wish we had more time today. It's been a pleasure for me, and it's an eye-opener, and I hope you people have enjoyed listening to these lovely ladies and tell us about themselves. I want to thank you very much. You've been delightful guests.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, my friends, coming up tomorrow on AM, a behind-the-scenes look at the new TV fall season, including a sneak preview of Dynasty and Dallas. Real cliffhangers. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. I hope you've enjoyed today's program. I know I did. I've learned a good bit. But join us again tomorrow on AM Chicago. Thank you very much for your time. Until next time, Art Fleming. Bye now.
Speaking, may I help you?
This is Pat Vance. She works for one of Chicago's largest banks as an operations assistant dealing with the stock market.
So we have silk wool and solid wool.
Mike Hodges is a salesman at a rather conservative men's store. Ellen Valancourt is a graphics designer. All normal jobs, all normal workers. You might pass them on the street and not give them a second thought as to how they spend their evenings.
She has a ball like a she. A punk rocker, she is a punk rocker now.
They spend some of the evenings here at Neo's, a bar on North Clark Street. A bar frequented mainly by, and they don't like the term, punk rockers. Wild hair, crazy clothes. Some wear several earrings all at once, men and women. That's in their spare time.
It was just part of the lifestyle. And it was fun, and it's fun to get dressed up, and it's also sort of a statement. So I respect my workplace. I feel that one can have more than one aspect to a personality, actually. And there is a difference between work and play.
Ellen Valancourt, first name spelled L-N, used to look like this 2 years ago and miles away in Cincinnati.
I did it as a personal statement. In a creative field such as this, I think maybe I'm a little more likely to get away with it because I think people maybe anticipate it a little more, or they think that artists are kind of carefree and do what they want anyway.
Well, during the day I work as a salesman and my job is to be traditional look, and at the nighttime I change. I wear different clothes, bowling shirts, t-shirts, jeans.
What about your hair, for instance?
Well, usually it stands straight up in the air.
He knows my feelings. I want him to dress a certain way in the store.
Dean Martin, no relation to the comedian and singer, is Mike Hodges' boss.
And it is fad, contrary to what a lot of the people think. Punk will not last. It will come and go.
It is a business at this hairstyling salon on North Wells. Even the employees get into the act. Dyeing hair, sometimes strange colors. Cutting, teasing, using a gel, they say, keeps the hair sticking straight up. A salon for men and women seems to be one of the main meeting places for those who like things just a bit different. Their lives are very different as night from day.
Monitor to 5 takes a look at Chicago's punk rockers.
So we have silk wool and solid wool.
Mike Hodges is a salesman at a rather conservative men's store. Ellen Valancourt is a graphics designer. All normal jobs, all normal workers. You might pass them on the street and not give them a second thought as to how they spend their evenings.
She has a punk rocker, she has a punk rocker, she has.
spend some of the evenings here at Neo's, a bar on North Clark Street, a bar frequented mainly by, and they don't like the term, punk rockers. Wild hair, crazy clothes, some wear several earrings all at once, men and women. That's in their spare time.
It was just part of the lifestyle. And it was fun, and it's fun to get dressed up. And it's also sort of a statement. So I respect my workplace. I feel that one can have more than one aspect to a personality, actually. And there is a difference between work and play.
Ellen Valancourt, first name spelled L-N, used to look like this 2 years ago and miles away in Cincinnati.
I did it as a personal statement. In a creative field such as this, I think maybe I'm a little more likely to get away with it because I think people maybe anticipate it a little more, or they think that artists are kind of carefree and do what they want anyway.
Well, during the day, I work as a salesman, and my job is to be traditional look. And at the nighttime, I change. I wear different clothes, bowling shirts, t-shirts, jeans.
What about your hair, for instance?
Well, usually it stands straight up in the air.
He knows my feelings. I want him to dress a certain way in the store.
Dean Martin, no relation to the comedian and singer, is Mike Hodges' boss.
And it is fad, contrary to what a lot of the people think. Punk will not last. It will come and go.
It is a business at this hairstyling salon on North Wells. Even the employees get into the act. Dyeing hair, sometimes strange colors. Cutting, teasing, using a gel they say keeps the hair sticking straight up. A salon for men and women seems to be one of the main meeting places for those who like things just a bit different. Their lives are very different as night from day.
Most of the so-called punkers Monitor 5 talk with stress their creativity. The hair and clothes is their way of letting the world know just who they are. And seeing them in the daytime, you might not know them, but when they're dressed for the evening, Ron and Linda, you can't miss them.
What do some punk rockers choose? And in today's Odyssey, we show you some colorful punk creations and their creators. Those hairstylists are at the Mark James Salon on North Wells. The photographic stylists for Channel 5 were Dick Smith, Carl Hickman, and Warren Teuber, with some colorful editing today by Lou Benton.
James Hair Salon. It's a salon that's noted for, well, a different style of haircut.
Here in the heart of Old Town, the Mark James Salon is a leader in the avant-garde. They create hairstyles that in the past have been stereotyped as being rebellious, violent, punk. But those stereotypes are changing, and Ruth Jacobs, owner of the salon, knows why.
It's becoming fashionable, and it's a way of art. We create art on heads instead of on canvas. We create a shape, color, style, design.
Lauren.
Mark Stein. Have a seat. What am I doing for you today, Laura?
Well, I'd like something different.
All right. How long has it been since you've had anything done to your hair?
It's been 2 years, and I'm really tired of a 9-to-5 look.
I'll see what I can do for you.
Could you imagine seeing a bank teller with a green mohawk? Obviously, new wave hairstyles are not for everyone, and not in everyone's budget. The first cut can cost as much as $50, and with the addition of colors and shades, the price climbs quickly. Mark Stein is head stylist and owner.
The most important thing is that the person feels good about themselves and how they express that. I'm just the executor of their feeling. Basically, I'm putting together style with personality.
And just what do these personalities think of their new hair?
I like very interesting and very drastic haircuts. I think it has an effect on the way I look at my face. I get to change my cosmetics often as to the color of my hair. I just find it very interesting.
The shape, I like the way it's shaped to my face. It just makes me happier. I'm happier with my hair.
What do your friends think of your hair?
I get different reactions. Some people like it, some people can't stand it.
What do your friends think of your hair?
They think it's great.
If my friends could see me now, hi girls, it's me.
Turning the page to entertainment, we'll take a look at the latest big budget nighttime soap.